Hello everyone.
Yeah, welcome to Art World Studio. This is Anuja and I welcome you for the day 3 of our tutorial of our workshops. And let me first check if my voice is going through very nicely and the audio and the video. So please type a yes so that I get to know that it is all going through and we are good to start. So we are going to start with our day 3. We have done day 1 as our borders, which was in black and white, how to draw them. The day 2 of the workshop was with coloring, how to do the color, how to do the base of the color, and then to lay the design. Now today we are going to do, okay, I got a yes and good. Okay, thank you, Jyoti. So today we are going to do the day 3, and day 3 will take you forward with the figures. When we draw a figure, the full figure comes late. First, generally what happens, most of the pictures, people don't draw the full figure, they just confine to the face. So the face study is very important because you can you may or may not eliminate the body, but the face is a mandate, so face has to be there. So today we will do the study of how to draw the face in this particular style, which is Patachitra. Now Patachitra, somebody corrected me on my pronunciation, thank you so much. It is Odisha, and yes, so it is from Odisha, and it is a very traditional art form. It is done on the patta or the canvas, which is made from the cloth. I can't do painting while fine liners and tube paints. I will talk about what you can paint. Today we are going to do the tutorial on how the features are made, how the eyes are, nose, the side of the face. Generally in these Patachitra paintings, we see that mostly the profile is done. So profile is the side angle of the face. And mostly what are the subjects are the gods and the goddesses. So gods and goddesses are made either as an idol, means just seated and or the standing posture, while some are in their kriya, the postures are while they are like Krishna Leela. If we see that Krishna is in lot of has a lot of motion throughout the picture. So as a child, as with Radha, so you will see a lot of movement in the body. Few idols, they will be stated straight, whereas a few are seated. There's a very distinctive style, and only few structures are accepted in here, very traditionally. Today we will do the side profile of the male and the female, how to draw the demons and other structures also, how to draw their faces, so that we get the whole idea of how to put everything in a painting. So for today, I will set it down here on my table and I will brief you on what all stuff you need. So what we are needing today is you can take the fine liners. It is the A4 size cartridge paper that I'm using, and today you can use a pencil. If you're not very comfortable, you can use a pencil. You can also use any gel pen that there are there. You can also use a fine liner or a waterproof pen. So totally depends on your choice what you want to take in today. We are not doing painting, and we will be just doing the drawing part, knowing what the face looks like and how is it different from different art forms. So we have already done Kalamkari, and Kalamkari and Patachitra, many of you get confused. Many of us get confused if you do not know about how the details and the distinctive style of the painting is. So we will start with the day 3 of our Patachitra. So today I am using as a uniball pen. It's a waterproof, though I'm not going to paint. So you can use any of the gel pen also. So it is a Patachitra, day 3 of our workshop, and we are going to learn about faces, different types of faces. of different character, how it changes, how the eye changes, how evil faces or the subtle faces are made. I welcome you all. Thank you for so many hellos. Okay, so we will start with the faces, and the first face that we will take today is a female side face. So how to do a female side face? Generally, we figure out that, okay, there has to be a structure. How do you start? So it is a structure which is, I'll just adjust the camera a little probably here. So this is a side face profile. And how to do the side face? Just imagine, this is what I'm doing with pencil, is just the imagination of the face. So while you are doing, just imagine that it's a circle. And how do we go ahead with it? The head part is a little turned. It's not a straight. And just a second, let me adjust the camera for a minute. I hope you all can view it well. Just a second, I think it's... there. Here we start with it. So this is the nose. The noses are pointed, they are pointed, and the lips are a little protruded, means going a little out. Now I'm following the same curve of the face and I'm going downwards. This is the chin. So this is the side of the face. Here I'm doing the jewelry part. This is the head, the hair, the ear. Now here, if we are doing a lady, then we can put a lot of jewelry. I'm putting a side jewelry for the ear. Like this. So here, okay, or is it flipped? Don't worry, you can make it a left side or a right side face, that is okay. Now, this is the head. I'm following the same curve of the circle. And this is the bun. Now you can have the style like open hair, tied in a bun, or a plait, or free flow. Whatever your wish is, you can just go ahead with that. Now, the eyebrows are well defined, Just give it a little thickness. The eyelid and the eye. Filling it the whole thing with this. Now, I hope this is clear. Now the problem of the camera went. So here, now this is a very distinctive style of these kheris that are there in a different form of art, which is kalamkari. We just make the loops. So I'm just giving this decoration on the jura. Like this. Your designing of the face can be according to your wish, but yes, there is a lot of decoration. This going on to the head, depending on what we are making, we will do the head gear. If in case we are doing a goddess, then it will be more elaborate and we have to do the full crown and the mukut. But if we are doing a normal attendant of the god, or just devotees or anything, or just gopiya, then we don't have to do it that elaborate. So it's more casual. Now, going on to this distinctive style, it is very easy, just getting a knack of it. Here, probably just make these curves to whatever length you want and then curve it like this. So this is what will make this kind of a shape, very easy shape. And then I will just end it up here. The hair can be black or with the lines. Or with other embellishments here, maybe flowers or the ornamental jewelry for the hair. We can do that. So this is the hair. The ear. Now the neck. There will be folds in the neck. Generally, the figures, the faces are the faces that we look are quite rounded up. And when we see the body is very thin and curvy, especially the waist portion. You will see a lot of twist. Now this is the decoration for the neck. Just see the center, and the opposite image will be taken on the other side. Now, since it is facing on the other side, for the nose ring, we do it on the other side also, or here, whatever your wish is, you can add the nut. If you want to make a serious look, it can be like this. With just a dot, you can make your picture look very smiling and pleasant, and that is a dot towards this part. If there is a dot over here, it suddenly looks like automatically. It's a very cheerful face. We will do a lot many faces. You will get the knack of it. You finding it hard. Probably if you practice, it's going to come easy for you. So now I'll just do it till the shoulder, and then we'll go to the other face study, because figures I will be taking up in the other session. So this is the front. Generally, this is the dress that comes on the chest. So later on, the same figure can go, but this is just a profile that is suggesting you that it is a side face. Now, a very, very distinctive and very peculiar style in this is some ties. Ties as in whatever we are drawing, the threads would be flowing. They flowy threads with a little tassels. So the tassels have a dot with a curve. This is a very distinctive style. You will see it in white, black, any color, whatever suits the picture. So this is a very important feature of Pattachitra. So wherever it is, probably some tying on the, of the necklace. So it is there. Tying of the crown, whatever you want to do, just think reasonably where it will fall. But this is one style that you will see mostly. Like this. For the hand, for if it is like any ornamentation on the hand, bajuband or anything, any ornament that you do, generally the clasps are not there and it is into a thread tie. Like this. So this is a side face. You can have the design on the dress as per your wish. They are highly ornamented, so they look very beautiful. Like this. So this is a general lady figure that we have done. Now I will be telling you a different form, how to do it, the lady figure in the front face. So generally, when we are talking about the figures, then they come as a profile. But when we are doing the goddesses, where the idols are placed, we do see the front profile. So when we do the front profile, it's of a goddess. If it is a five face, anything, any god, they can be depicted like this. A five face of the goddess, or Hanumanji with five faces, Brahma, or whatever god it is, the Vishnu with all forms, then we will have a front face definitely. So we are going to study for the front face, and we are going to do the goddess, where I will be telling you about the crown as well. So here, going on the front face, take the how much ever big face you have to make. Now this has to be divided. You have to check the face and the crown. Generally, if it's a study of the face of the goddess, the face, if I take it from here to here, this big face, I will have to take the similar or more as the crown. So this proportion should be kept in mind when we are doing. So more elaborate over here. Now here you have to imagine a little oval here. I'm just giving it a nice cup shape, a curved cup. That's it. And this is the place where the crown will come. So what is very important is that the tip of the crown aligns with the center of the face. This is a very important thing to be kept in mind when you are drawing a picture front face. So the tika, the nose, the lips, the chin, and the tip of the crown and the design that is supposed to be the center of the crown should come in alignment. So here I will start. This is the only thing that we are supposed to do here. Now, check on the face. I am giving it a side. And now, very much depends on what type of face you are doing. You may or may not make a very distinctive chin. Here I'll do a very small chin like this. I'm putting a bindi to plot where I have the center of the face. The eyebrows. Working left and right will help you to get alignment proper. But it is just my take on it. I just do it left and right together. So, two eyebrows. Now for the eyes, eyes are generally thin. Generally thin, not very wide. So we'll start, but long. Like this. The eyelid is a very distinctive feature. Do make an eyelid. And the eyes. Now, depending on where the eye is positioned, it can see front, it can see down, it can see up. I will tell you with the pencil. If it is up, it is showing like this. It is halfway up. If it is in the center, the full ball is seen. And if it is down, so if in case it is down, then the lower part, only the lower part will be seen. So in that case, the eye will go like this. Generally, these kind of eyes are done for demons and characters are there. We do, like for Ravan, we will do it when Shiva is sitting on the mountain and he's pressing it, and then he's just getting bewildered. Then that is one. Here I will do a very calm look and doing the front look like this. Now we generally do a light and a dark shade in this, taking the nose right from there in a continuation. Nostrils and the center part. So this is the nose. A straight line for the lips. As I told, if we make the ends a little dotted, it looks smiling. So here. Now the ear will come from the eye, and this is the ear portion. I am adding design or the jewelry to the ear, and then continuing it down. Same design on the other side. See to it that both of them are of the same size. So this here, in this, now you can do the further designing of it. For the forehead, this was the line. I am making a small tikka here. Now this totally depends on what design you draw. Yes, of course, Kavita. Kavita is writing, if I do practice, will I get it? Yes, you will definitely get this everything. Now, here, I am giving it the side of the crown. Now, this spacing is not curved, and here I will add the hair. You may add curves or you may add single line, whatever your design of the hairstyle is, you can just add that. I'm adding some designs right here. And this will be the hair, the backside will be the hair. You may give a side band for the hair as well. Now here this can be a single dot for the bindi, or if you want to add the eye, you may add the eye also. Here. This is a form which you can do. This is a variation. You can leave it like the way it was before, or you can do it. So this is the face part. Now we'll go to the neck. And then in the neck, we see that there are bands, the folds of the neck, followed by very elaborate neck piece, very heavy design. So here I'm extending the ear, earring. And this is my band for the. You may choose to do whatever design you want for the for this part. I'm just adding curves. Now we'll go to the top part, how to fix this. Now when the crown starts, it doesn't start right away. We have to do a little bit of more layering, the thickness of the or the border. So it will have a little more width than the face. So if your face is this much, your crown will add a little width here because of the thickness of the now doing the center. They can be n number of designs for the crown and the side one here. Keep the symmetry in mind and then you can like this. Now going to the top of it, just giving it a side check to it that it is balanced. And a small feature that is very distinctive here in this kind of a design is the rounded form in the mukut. So in the mukut, it is not a continuous, it is layered. And it is like this. So I'll create the design here. So I'm just doing a little section. Like this, this is the main structure of it. Like this. So this is the front. You can just fill up the center as well. Whatever design you want to do, you are free to do in this. So this I leave it to the choice. Whatever is your choice, you can work on this. Right. Now I will be moving to the little how to do the shoulder in the front facing figure. This will give you the idea of how to do the a little a bit of more jewelry part, which is distinctive, which is a different form. When we do the ladies or a any female, be it a goddess or a general female, we would be dividing here for the shoulder. And how the jewelry will go is, first it will go straight and then it will go U. Reason being that the chest is placed over here and the jewelry will not go just straight. If we are doing Shiva, Vishnu, any male god, then the jewelry, all the garlands will go up straight. So they will be hanging. Whereas when you're doing a female deity, then just continuously go like this, and with a U. Now it depends on how much of the length you want. You can also do small or big scallop designs to make it like curves or beads, whatever you wish. You can just do it. I'm just giving you the idea of the main thing that you have to keep in mind. Generally, they are in the layers and we do not have a lot of gaps in the middle. So you can add multiple designs in the middle. So this would be the front of the goddess or the figure. This is the side and this is the front. Now there are different variations in the eye depending on what goddess we are making. Few of the eyes I will show you here. I will just zoom in a little. So the eye can be thin If we are making somebody relaxed or in meditation, then the eye will be like this. The eye can also be, so with the eyebrow here I'm making this. It can also have curved, very curvy eyes like this. And when we are making Hanuman, when we are making God Hanuman in meditation or doing Ram Bhajan or anything like that, then the eyes turn like this. For few, we would do very big eyes, and these are for any of the, when it is narrating a story from the gods, then the eyes will be for the demons or for any character that has the evil side. Now, after this, there's one more thing. You may or may not add the eyelids. If in case you eyelids you want to add, you will be adding only to the lower lid, not to the upper lid. This is very different and very peculiar feature of this. But is not all the way important. If you want to do it, you may. That is totally the choice of the person who is making it. Eyelid. Like this. So, more rounded, more open. Now, as I was talking about the scared face, or then we make the eyes like this. Is a set of eyes where it is rounded on the top, straight at the bottom, and the eyes are the eye, these pupils, they are facing down. So whenever we make Kali or Goddess Kali or any Mahishasurvad or anything like that, then we will be doing this kind of eye. Now, these things do change with the characters. With the characters, you can have a very subtle eyes like this with Radha, or meditative eye, or really in anger or scare. You can just do these. Aharna, you have to fix it. There's nothing, draw it with a pencil. And then if in case your proportions are a little not so, you're not so happy with the proportions, you'll have to fix a little of this. So this, now I will be doing the side face or the front face. I'll show you how to do the Rishi, Muni and other things as well. We will start with that. You have to fix it. If you feel that one eye is up or down, one chest is up or down, you have to fix it. Now, going on to the face of, the side face of the god, okay, we are doing the Krishna. Again, we will be doing the, probably, if we are taking, which form of Krishna are we taking? If we are doing the Vishnu form and we have to add the mukut on it, it's the other scenario. If we are doing the shepherd or the gwala or Anything, you have to see how much space you have to leave it on the top. So here I am doing a very simple face of Krishna in his very famous state, and that is just holding a bansuri. Like this, nose, lip a little protruded like this. Chin and the neck portion. Here, going to the side of the head, now this depends on what hairstyle you want to make. Like this. You can also make a curved chin inside. This is the side. Now I may add a little bit of the crown. I'll show you how it will be. Like this. Very important thing. This mor mukut. This. Now, when we are making this or this for this female figure also, we can add some of these decorations. Generally, the background against the deity is all in flat colors. Flat colors means without any shade, it will be all straight coloring. And then with the opposite color, these things come really beautiful. So, like so. Like this, you may add few. Generally, these tassels are more flowy and runny when you see the gopis or anybody in the movement. So this, here is a Krishna face. Again, the same design goes further with the same kind of design depending on what, how much ever you want to do with it. So these are few. I will do one Rishi. How to do a Rishi, a saint. So those who have, yeah, one more request. Those who have not subscribed, do subscribe. And those who want to post their work can also join me on my Facebook group, which is Arthral Studio. There you can post all your, share all your drawings as well. Yes, it is. The nose is often sharp, so it is very sharp here also. In the front, you won't be able to see, but when we paint, then we put a white tip over here that shows the highlighted area. So the nose, the protruded thin lips, and the chin part, everything here is very very different from other forms. So you will see this rounded curve of the face, that is a very distinctive style. Faces are more rounded and the figure, the whole body structure is very thin and curvy. So there are many things that where you can check your Pattachitra. Now, the Rishi, how do we do? Again, the same, the for any of the face, you will have to do the same kind of a thing. Imagine you being making a, you making a circle. Okay. Now, after that, how it will all go in a circle? The nose. You will see that the nose is often pointing down. It is not straight. So it, you will see that it is going down. The tip of it is going down. These are very, very small minutes. Then the lip also is going and it is thin. Right here. I'm taking this here. So if you happen to make any of the illustration where you have to do the court scene and advisors, those vidwans, those who are sitting, or Rishi or Muni, then you can just do this form. So these are the beads, you have to do the beads, and you can just, this is how you can get the idea of this. There's a very important thing for this, we will talk about that when we will start with the colors, is that the corners of the eye of this kind of pictures of Pattachitra is will have a little bit of a red in it. I'll just add a little pen so that you get the idea of it, though we will work on a colored form, how to do it later. I'll just show you there. So this is how it comes. So very little, but just a teeny tiny drop of red. So this is there. Yes, all of the hair definitely will have the same thing. If we have to do a sage or someone, then you can also add the mustache. But when we do the mustache of the kings, demons, or anybody who has ego or ego position, then we will do the mustaches a little going up. Whereas when we are doing the Rishi and Muni, just make them go down like this, very relaxed and poised. So this can be one form. When we make for the kings, we do the mustaches a little up high. When we do it for demons, of course, a little more big, elaborate, because it was considered to be the big ego thing. So that was there. Now, just showing you a form of a demoness, or how do we work on that? So this will give you the whole idea of how to deal with all the characters. So the faces of demons are actually made a little big, and their body is also made a little bit bigger. So here, going around, going again and doing the big circle, slightly bigger. And now, there will be no headgears, their hair will not be tied, so there will be free hair, ornamentation will be very less. So these are the few features. Now here, just showing the rudeness of the face, you will see that there is a dent, the nose is big, and the curve is even bigger. There is no smile on the face. Bulkier, bigger face. Probably my circle has gone a little smaller according to the way I'm drawing. So it's just, but it is in a circle, of course. Just, and the hair will go flowing. So I'll just erase off the circle, because it is a deceptive thing now, right? When you make the eyebrow, you have to make the frown. So for that, you will make like this, a hooked eyebrow. The eyelid. The eyes big. Full big. I'm making the eyeball also big here. Yeah? Now these things are not very important. They may have horns or they may not have horns, right? Without any design, just hoops. Bigger eyelashes. And for the red also, they'll have more red in the eye. Now, you may or may not have these fangs. So it is totally upon the illustration that you are picking on, the character that you are making. It's very much depending on that. You may have it, you may not have it. You may have the horns, you may not have the horns. But the features will, the eyebrow, this frown will change. This is a frown where if you want, you can make the this. This a small hook on the top gives a little more expression, a little more. Thank you. Thank you so much, Kavita. Yes, I really want this to happen. Thank you. And if you all are learning, it's a big pleasure for me. So these are the basic forms. And now from tomorrow, from tomorrow we will start with the colors also, and we will do the gods. So you all have to stay tuned and be a part of it to learn each and every small details, that because one picture will only deal with one character, but it is not the overall study of the Patachitra form. So there are few possibilities, few changes that you will see in different kinds of forms, but few traits, few distinctive features that will go throughout the style. So there is one style, but the style and the depiction of the character is vastly dependent on the character that you're building. So whatever you are painting, your style, your expression, your little bit of accessories, everything will change. But you have to stay in one style. So that is the beauty of the traditional forms. And that's how it is. And if you like it, just press the like button. So I get to see how many like it. And if you're working on it, definitely you will get it. Do not get disheartened if you're not getting the thing in one go. That is why we have planned this session, wherein you will get the study of it, the overall analysis of the thing, how the things change, and what is the main thing that is flowing everywhere. So when we talk about the spaces, you will see that this circle form, I'm repeating it every time. So I'm repeating this circular form no matter how the face changes. So all these different characters will have one distinctive style. The nose, the lips, these are not changing at all. The size, the expression is changing. So the eyes, different kind of eyes, how they will be. Then how the profiles of the side and the front will be. We will deal it with fish mouth. We will do it when we will do the different forms. So if anybody has any question on it, if you have any requests, like you want this particular picture or this particular form, you can write it to me and then I'll get it back to you and I'll try to incorporate that. Yes, the R goes very fast. That's good. Okay, thank you everyone. Thank you everyone, and I will see you tomorrow at 3, and tomorrow we are going to do the paints. So you will see the whole picture taking form in paints. And yeah, what we are going to do is a surprise. You'll get to know tomorrow. Okay, so thanks for being with me, and I will catch you up tomorrow at 3 o'clock in my live session. Thank you. Bye-bye.